Vibe coding means telling an AI what you want your program to do in plain language, and the AI writes the code for you. In this video, we are going to do some English learning related vibe coding using three different tools. We're going to use Claude, we're going to use Replit Agent, and we're going to use V0. We're going to see what we can make. So it's going to be kind of playful and exploratory. I am not a developer. I know some, you know, basic website stuff. I can edit HTML and CSS, but that's it. Okay, I'm not a developer. I don't know how to write code. So I want to see what's possible just using my brain, my imagination, my creativity, and describing what I want clearly. What can I build? So, okay, let's start in Claude. Build a one-page English streak tracker I can open in any browser. Streak tracker would be tracking days in a row that I complete something or weeks in a row that I complete something. Show my current streak in weeks. A year view calendar of 52 small squares marks each week. Green if I met the goal, red if I didn't, gray for the current week. Below the calendar sits a checklist for the current week with six skill areas: listening, speaking, reading, writing, vocabulary, pronunciation, each starting with two example tasks. I can rename, add, or delete tasks and change their prompt values for that week through an edit tasks toggle. Okay, and here are just some details for how I want things to be laid out. Basically, when I create a prompt, I like to organize things with headings and then a description for each one, and I consider those kind of knobs within a prompt that I can tune and turn. I'm not saying this is going to work perfectly. This is, again, just kind of exploring. The problem with being a vibe coder is that you don't know how to actually fix anything. So when you get a mistake or something doesn't look right, you have to just say, please make it different, or please fix this for me. Copying and pasting error messages, fix this, right? This is the plight of the poor vibe coder. But you know, it's just playing around. This is not too serious, okay? And then I want a streak counter, total points, whatever it is, out of 30. And I want a single HTML file that I can open in a browser. All right. Okay, so here's what we've got. I see the current week. I can edit tasks. Finalize week. I don't see the year view. Okay, we got an error message. We'll ask to fix this. Seriously, after one attempt, I've hit the limit? Okay, here we go. It's basically trying to get me to upgrade, saying that it can't even attempt to fix the mistakes. So I wonder if Replit can build it. Let's try the same thing in Replit. Replit agent. Same exact thing. Okay, here's what Replit came up with. There's my year view. I've got 52 weeks. The ones that are done, apparently I have failed every single week because they're red. And I'm on week 14. Am I actually on week 14? I don't know, but let's go with it and see if this works. So did I do all of these things? Under listening, I watched a YouTube video in English, listened to a podcast, speaking, pronunciation, had a conversation, reading, read an article, 10 pages in a book. I wrote a paragraph in English, and I replied to an email, vocabulary. Let's just say I did absolutely everything. Fantastic. Okay. And 30 points is the number of points I need to successfully complete the day. So I've done everything. So I've got 60 out of 30. Finalize week. Now this should turn on the... Hey, it turned it green. So that's pretty cool. This actually works. So I can't retroactively go back, but this actually works. I have a tracker with a checklist. I need to reach 30 points in order to pass, which means doing half of these things, I think. And can I edit them? Okay. Wow. Okay, let's say I want to edit speaking. I want to change speaking to talk to ChatGPT for 30 minutes. And this is going to be worth, I don't know, 20 points. Okay. The value must be less Less than or equal to 10. Okay. All right. Let's do 10. And so if I save that, what happens? Okay. Is that working? Save. Okay. Let me cancel. Let's see. Maybe I need to delete one and then add it. So let me delete practice for 10 minutes. Now let me add one. Now let's save. Does that work? No, that doesn't work. Okay. So that's something I would have to improve. But the edit page is almost functional. I mean, it looks good. If I could actually submit the edits, then it would be fully functional. What happens if I go back to this week? Can I go back? No, I can only go to the next week. So if I were going to maybe try something else, I would maybe work on the edit function so that I could submit edits. I would want to change this view so that I could go back and retroactively edit. And I might improve the year view a little bit. I'm not sure why this is showing Q1, Q2, Q3, and Q4. I don't think, is that correct? Is that actually, no, that can't be right. Because it would be, maybe Q1 would be what, around, I don't want to count the weeks, but it would not be this. Okay. But overall, I like it. And it's pretty functional. It's giving me ideas. Oh, and there's the current streak. That's cool. 1 week. So next week, if I do it again, 2 weeks. Very cool. I'm not going to try to deploy it. There are too many things to fix. Here, I'm just kind of playing, exploring ideas. I think this is a good one. I like the idea, and I think this actually works, kind of. Okay, now back to Claude. Somehow, I was able to get Claude working again. I shared the error message, and now Claude is giving me a pretty decent view here. It looks very similar. All right. So if I go through and check these are worth different point values. If I go through and check, that should be enough, right? That should be more than 30 points. Yeah, that's 45. Okay, finalize week. What happens? Does it turn green? Does it turn green? No, it doesn't turn green. Do I have to select all of them? No, this one is not. It looks good, but it didn't turn green. And there was an edit button, but now I don't see it. So it doesn't seem to be working functionally as well as the one that we made with the Replit agent. So let's actually do the next project with the Replit agent. I'm over Claude. Sorry, Claude. Okay, so back to Replit agent. Create a tile-based phrasal verbs matching game called Tile Phrase Pairup. The goal is to match verbs with the right particles and meanings to build correct phrasal verbs. Tiles, there are verb tiles, particle tiles, and meaning tiles. The board should be a 4x4 grid. One row holds verbs, one holds particles, one holds meanings. And this is what I do for each turn. I drag the tiles around. So this is fairly simple, and I'd like to add a countdown mechanic. But we'll see what we can do with this. While that's going, let's go over to V0. What I want to build here is a first-person game where I'm encountering other characters, NPCs, who give me grammar challenges. I want it to be very immersive. Again, a 3D game. So the core idea, the player roams a single, peaceful, low-poly forest clearing. Friendly animal NPCs offer grammar challenges, correct answers, heal the grove, and advance progress. So these are some movement instructions. I want to use the keyboard for NPCs. I want 5 stationary NPCs, an owl, a squirrel, a badger, a heron, and a fox. I want to basically trigger the dialogue panel when I'm within a certain distance of each one. And again, I'm going to be trying to handle grammar challenges to heal the forest. Okay, let's go. Now let's go back to the Replit agent. Okay, the phrasal verbs matcher is ready. All right, so here's a full screen view. Let's try this out. Start game. Uh-oh, I need to zoom out. Sorry for the bad viewing experience here. Uh-oh, 21 seconds left. The timer is running down. To stop sleeping is to wake up. To search for information is to look up, and to record information in writing is to write down. Now what do I do? What do I do? What do I do next? I need to drag it. Time's up. You ran out. Wow, this actually works. Wow, I'm very impressed. Oh, I need to stop talking and actually do this. Okay, to record information is to write down. To search for information is to look up. And then throw away is the last one. And then I drag it to here. I drag it to here. And I drag it to here with 9 seconds left. I click submit. Hey, score 60. That actually works. Time remaining 6 seconds left. Multiplier 10x, whatever that means. Next level. Whoa, now there are more. This is actually fun. To meet someone by chance is to run into. To find something by chance is to come across. To lift something from a surface is to pick up, and to take care of something or someone is to look after. And then this, and then this, this, and then this, and then this, and then submit. And you, 6 seconds left. Success. Total score 120. Wow, that's actually kind of fun. Whoa. Oh, okay. Now I have to do more. All right. So it's increasing it. So I guess, you know, visually there's some work to do, but it's cool and it works. And I can actually move through the levels. So Replit is really cool for just trying stuff out and playing with ideas. I mean, so far, Replit's been the one that makes things actually work and usable as a demo experience. Pretty cool. All right, so let's go and see how our 3D game is doing. It looks like it's done. Okay, can I try it out? Open in a new tab. Here we go. Grammar Grove, loading the magical forest. Okay, I'm trying to move around using the moving keys. But I can't do that, but I can look. Okay, so that's good. I can look, but I'm not able to actually move. Okay, I'll just press E to interact here. Okay, so I'm not able to move, and I'm not able to interact with the NPCs. That's a problem. Okay, back to the drawing board. Let's try something else out here. Okay, so after some vibe coding and trying to fix things, I've made a few variations. Now we have the Lingua Labyrinth. It's still a grammar challenge. Hopefully we can actually move around. It looks like we can. It looks like we can. Pretty cool. Can I look? Yes. All right. So let's go in. Oh, I can go right through the walls. All right, that's something to fix, I guess. Okay, and let's talk to Lexica. Can I type E here? Okay, that doesn't work, but I can click accept challenge. Verb tense challenge. By the time we arrive, the movie something already. That's a tough one. Will have started. Okay. I something to the store yesterday when I met my friend. I was going to the store yesterday when I met my friend. She's something in this city since 2010. She has lived in this city since 2010. I got them all right. Continued journey. Very good. Nice. Okay, who else can I talk to? Is this a wall? Where is Professor Syntax? Is Professor Syntax on the other side? Oh, Professor Syntax is in the wall. Professor Syntax is in the wall. Now I'm looking sideways. All right, I gotta fix that. All right, I'm gonna go in the wall and talk to Professor Syntax here. Hello, Professor Syntax. I hope you're enjoying your time in the wall. I like how they're going woo, 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 up and down. If I something rich, I would buy a mansion. If I were rich, I would buy a mansion. If you had studied harder, you something the exam, you would have passed the exam. And then I'm going to get the third one wrong on purpose. Unless it's something tomorrow, we will go hiking. Unless it, the correct answer would be rains. I'm going to do unless it will rain. Oh, no. Okay, but still success. Your final score is 2 out of 3. Continue journey. I like this. So I kind of like, and it would be so cool if you could actually talk to the characters and answer, and it would be tied into a large language model, and it were interactive, and it had a story element, and it were in 3D, and you would get feedback as you go, but it's very immersive, and you have to kill monsters and stuff. Okay, it looks like I can't actually interact with whatever that is. Okay, so in theory, this is pretty cool. I mean, it's kind of working, and I think with some more expert vibe coding, I could make it work. I think the cool thing about all of this is just to explore ideas, to take your ideas, use your imagination, and put them into words, into clear descriptions that turn into a thing that you can play with, whether it's useful for English learning or not. The ones we explored, I think, are the tracker, right? The streaks tracker, the phrasal verbs matching game, which worked surprisingly well, and this, which has potential, but has a lot of limitations, I think, especially because it's just a sort of demo experience and, you know, we're not really building a game here. But it's fun to use my imagination and try to think through these ideas. Maybe someday I'll develop one of these further. Maybe someday I can actually build a full mobile game where it's immersive and I can use this kind of thing to test out my ideas, right, to see what things work and what things don't really work before investing a lot of time and money into something like a real mobile game, which I would love to do. So, I don't know, try these out. Play with them. Use your imagination and turn your imagination into words that make your ideas more real, somehow concrete. It's kind of like doing magic. It's pretty cool. If anyone out there is a real developer and is interested in exploring some of these ideas, I'm certainly interested and would love to collaborate on something like a game, an English learning game. So feel free to reach out to me if you're interested in something like that. Check out the 90-day program in the links in the description. That I do know something about. It's a great way to improve your spoken English, your English fluency. It keeps you accountable. You have assignments. There are over 50 hours of lessons. You complete those assignments based on the lessons and get feedback from AI assistants who know the content of the lessons and know how to give feedback. You have live conversations with AI agents as well. And you get my WhatsApp to get help and support throughout the program. And at the end, if you're not happy with your progress, you can get a full refund at the end of 90 days, which is something you won't see everywhere. I think that's a pretty great deal. You can do the entire program and then get a refund if you want, if you're not satisfied. So check it out. Links in the description. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.